it's a lie. I love the lie. Tear a blow to burn it out. She got cheap, but let's get not your phone. Where my pit that shin hill. I'm on a crumb diamonds. Kill it, I kill it myself. But no, I can't believe it. I can't do that. Can't do that shit anymore. I like being bad.
What's happening, everybody? Hello and welcome. Oh, cool. A bunch of guys showed up. What's going on? Nicole took the afternoon off from work. All right. An excuse. How's everybody doing? Hope you guys are doing well. Today, I'm going to be checking out TXT. They got this brand new album. It's called Thursday's Child. And I've been meaning to check this out for a little while. Let me pull up my stuff here. And I asked our Discord community, I said, hey, they got this new album. Everybody tells me it's fantastic. And I'd love some help putting together a stream to check out their new album, possibly some behind the scenes stuff, and basically just learn a little bit more about Tomorrow Together, which is what TXT stands for. And the latest song I heard from them was this song right here, Good Boy Gone Bad. I think it's got some really cool production elements and some interesting writing as well. And since they're tied to Big Hit and everybody says they're so good, I figured we might as well check out an entire album from them today. But today's stream is not really brought to you by me. I'm just the guy here who's going to be talking about the album. A lot of people put some effort into today's stream to make this thing happen. So today's stream, I guess, is sponsored by Myrrh, Kit, Candace, and Cabbage. They took time out of their day to put together this whole list and YouTube playlist and all sorts of fun stuff. So seriously, huge shout out to those guys, or gals, I should say. I think they're all gals. But yeah, this will be fun. They did send me this video link that I wanted to check out yesterday after work, but I just didn't get to it. By the time I got home, it was like 1 a.m. and I'm like, I was just too tired. But there's an explanation video that I might check out if I like this album and want to continue with these guys. I'm sad because I can't stay the whole stream, but I really want to see this. Oh, man. Sorry about that. Well, we got a lot of fun stuff coming up, though. The stream will be available here on Twitch and obviously on Patreon. I record the whole thing. Obviously, on Twitch, sometimes things get muted, so I like to record the whole thing for my friends over on Patreon. You're seeing them live in July? Oh, Autumn. Interesting. The Otter Dream Team? I know. I've got multiple dream teams now. This is it's getting pretty wild around here. You forgot, but you're glad you didn't miss this. Oh, man. Yeah, we got a fun week ahead of us. We're doing this today, obviously. And then I got Sunday stream coming up. I'm going to be listening to the last official album from BTS. That'll be a big fun stream. Then on Tuesday, I'm going to be doing another thing with my wife. Well, I'll probably show her some more new BTS. I was kind of worried about that last time, last Tuesday. I'm like, I'm going to show you some BTS. But I mean, if she didn't like it, she didn't like it. I wasn't going to push her towards it or anything, but she seems to be pretty fascinated. And I think she already has a bias. She doesn't know what that is yet, but she's got a little thing for V. She says she likes V. So I thought that was kind of cute. And then what else am I doing? And then probably some more scary stuff. Then Live Request Wednesday will be back. I had to skip out last week because of some sleeping issues I had. But Live Request Wednesday will be back this Wednesday, and we're going to probably continue the theme we had going from last week, which is going to be like Latino-themed music and Latino artists, so that'll be a cool time. I've been waiting since 2019. I couldn't get any. Okay. Super Tuna was fun, right? Yeah, I know. She really dug Super Tuna. I'm surprised she liked that one so much. I don't know. I'm going to have to start thinking of two or three songs I can show her for next Tuesday. If you guys have any ideas, send them to me in Discord. She tends to like the more upbeat stuff. I don't want to scare her away. I don't want to scare her away with too much information or else also too much of my bias. And I don't want to like, I'm trying to be as monotone when I'm with her with these things as possible. So I don't distract her from any of her reactions. You know, if I'm sitting there and I'm like, yeah, this is amazing, this is why it's amazing, you know, she's gonna feel influenced by, you know, by me. We just kind of, I mean, she's my wife. I feed off her energy, she feeds off my energy. So I want this thing to be as authentic as possible. So I'm just kind of sitting there, just kind of like slowly smiling and just watching her. But it's a really cute experience, and I think we're gonna continue with that. So I don't know, maybe I'll do Idol next week, or I don't know. I want to show her some more digestible songs. And then once I get her hooked in, like you guys hooked me in, then we'll get into the nook and cranny of things. If she's willing, if she even wants to do it. She enjoyed Boy With Love. Yeah, she really liked that one. Yeah, it'll be a good time. Ego's going to be good too. Yeah, I know. Ego would be a good one. I saw you wrote that on Patreon, Pam. And yeah, Ego's kind of what I'm leaning towards. Can't wait to see her reaction. I know. This whole thing is so foreign to her, like getting in front of a camera and doing whatever, but her watching me do it over the last year, she wants to be, you know, obviously this takes up a huge chunk of my time. And one of the main drawbacks of doing all these videos and live streams and everything is how time consuming it is. And that kind of means I have to spend less time with my wife, which is not ideal. You know, she's my best friend. She's like pretty much the only person I really want to be around in real life. So if I can include her and do this with her, then that means it's a win-win for me and for her too. So we get to hang out together and do the thing I love. But it's looking good. It's looking like she's having fun with it. So hopefully I can see if she'll want to continue, but things are looking good. But we're here to talk about TXT together today here. Let me switch screens here. Let's get into the show. Yeah. There's a ton of good ones. And I'm going to be asking for you guys' help probably like week two or three into this whole little thing. I think we're going to do it on Tuesdays for some, you know, hidden gems or whatever. So be on the lookout for what, you know, you think that she likes and songs you can do. Obviously, I'm not going to take her through the entire journey that I'm going through. I'm not going to make her start at the beginning and devote a year to this. So I have no problem jumping around, especially since I'll be caught up after this week. It's just a lot to ask of somebody to do that. That's like a year of time. But if she gets into it and she gets down with it and she wants to learn more about the personalities and stuff, like, I'd love to do Bon Voyage with her. I'd love to do some of like the Rise with her. I'd love to do all this stuff. And just it'd be fun for me to revisit stuff. You know, like the first couple episodes of Rise of Bangtan or some of like the Who is BTS documentaries that I watched when I first started, now having a clear context of like what these guys are and where they're going, that I can maybe even help explain things better to her at that time. So we got a lot of fun stuff on the run. I haven't done run in a while. That's what I was thinking, that XLS guide. Almost, yeah, exactly. Like one of those guides, like after I show her, maybe this week we'll do a couple more songs and then we'll do a guide. But again, if she's not into it, I'm not going to make her do it. If she's like, eh, it's okay. You know, not everybody falls down this rabbit hole as hard as I do or you do, you know, different songs for different people. But so far it's looking good. I mean, she really liked it. So that's, I was surprised. Then, yeah, that's the thing. Yeah. If she really likes it, then we can go to a concert together. That'd be fun. So TXT, let's get to the show here. Let's see here. So, as always, you know, I'm incredibly blessed with cool people that are willing to help me out. And like I said, the team that I mentioned earlier has put together this whole stream for us today. And they did it proper, just like I do with my BTS reactions, with a whole Google document here, kind of explaining the concept of the album and just a little bit of information along the way. So what do we know about TXT? Personally, me? Not a whole lot. I've heard a couple songs on Live Request Wednesday, which is a show we do where people request music of me. And it's been cool. It's been interesting. And it's definitely caught my eye. And I think these guys have a lot of potential. And especially since I've heard that they write a lot of their own music and there's some very talented people in this band. But the problem with doing Live Request Wednesday is I hear so much music back to back, every different kind of genre. And after a couple hours, you know, my brain just kind of turns to mush from all the different sound design and me just trying to, you know, formulate my thoughts and break songs and different genres like that, like over and over down, where it kind of turns my brain to mush by the time I'm done. And I feel bad because it's happened a couple times with TXT where I haven't really broken things down as much as I'd like to or talked about them as much as I could because I was trying to move the show forward. So today we're going to spend a little bit more time with them, get to know the guys a little bit, and get to know their latest album, which people tell me is absolutely phenomenal. Wow, phenomenal. So TXT stands for Tomorrow Together. The album's name is taken from the Monday's Child nursery rhyme. All right. Monday's child is fair of face. Tuesday's child is full of grace. Wednesday's child is full of woe. Thursday's child has far to go. Friday's child is loving and giving. Saturday's child works hard for the living. The child born on Sabbath day is bonny and bithel, good and gay. Yeah, I've never heard that rhyme before. It sounds like a nursery rhyme, but it's new to me. Sounds kind of religious, and I was raised as a Unitarian, I guess, which is kind of a hippie religion. It was like all religions in one. And we had like atheist and, you know, we even had witches and stuff in our church. It was kind of crazy. And we barely went. We just went on Easter. So I'm not very religious. I just don't know a whole lot about religion. So this one escaped me. You're excited to get more to know me? Me too. All right. So TXT specifically chose Thursday's child from the children's listed in the rhyme, as they believe, just like the child in the rhyme, that they still have far to go. They have more music to make and more music for fans to hear. This is their sixth consecutive album to chart on Billboard's 200, peaked at number 4. They have also announced their first world tour and most of the members writing credits on the album. Most of the members have writing credits on the album. Now we're talking. It's also the first album with no subnit songs. All 5 members participate in everything. Okay, so they don't have like solo tracks or all part of everything. Very cool. The album is available in 3 versions, and there is a hint of the album's theme, End Mess and Hate. Part of the pre-release productions from Big Hit include trending the keywords End TXT, TXT Mess, and Hate TXT on Twitter. Oh, shoot, man. I've just been learning about Twitter, and I just got back into it myself. That's interesting. So yeah, they use these hashtags. You guys probably know what Twitter is. I'm bad with it. Where is he reading this? This is the Google Doc that my team has sent me. So they have these hashtags, and they're kind of like NTXT, MessTXT, like in HateTXT. Like if I was to go on Twitter and see that, I would probably assume like there was some kind of crazy scandal or something. Like they did something horrible. So I guess that's kind of an interesting marketing angle, I guess. I'll have to go and search through that through Twitter. Actually, let's check it out right now. All right, I'm going to Twitter. Let's see if I can remember my password. All right. So let's go to HateTXT. Is there a whole thing here? Okay, yeah, there's tons of stuff. This is them on Twitter. That's obviously one of the guys. Yeah, it's such a weird angle. I guess it's like it would make me click on it because I would assume like the guys did something horrific. I'm like, oh boy, what's going on now? I repeat, you do not know TXT. You have no rights to hate TXT. They just because of what you've seen from them. You don't know how much they care for each other, even for MOAs. What the hell is MOAs? Kindly thank you and throw hateful words towards them because you'll embarrass yourself at the end. So this is probably either a person that's confused by the, you know, the tagline, or she was just, I don't know, getting some hate or something. I don't know. I hear Twitter's kind of a cesspool sometimes. It's been fun for me. It's been fun for me getting back into it this week. Yeah, people aren't, look at this. So people are confused. You hate TXT? Pick and choosing. I hate TXT. Who hates TXT? It feels like people don't understand this this trend here. It's a ballsy move from TXT. It's a ballsy move from TXT to have those kind of like marketing terms, NTXT, hate TXT, and TXT mess. You would immediately think that they'd gotten some kind of scandal. All right, so that's Twitter. And if you want to follow me on Twitter, it's at JimGames at YouTube or at JimGames at YT. All right, let's get back to this thing. So that's interesting. The album tells the story of a boy's first breakup and how he experiences the 5 stages of grief through the emotions of denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. Okay, so this is what kind of really made me want to check out this album is because it's a concept album, and I love concept album. I didn't know exactly what the 5 stages of grief were supposed to represent, if the grief was loss or what it was, but it seems like it's about a breakup and the different stages you go through. And, you know, I was once a boy and I experienced some pretty painful breakups, you know, in my younger years, my early 20s. And, yeah, it fucking rocked my world, man. It really did. I didn't think I'd ever get over it. And obviously I did. Time heals all wounds. But okay, so they break it down into denial, which I guess is fair. You know, at first I'm like, why is this ending? This isn't actually ending. Anger, being angry with the person, bargaining, you know, say I'll change or do whatever, they'll change, depression and acceptance. That seems pretty fair. That seems kind of pretty much the order that I went through, my emotions, I guess. Moving from adolescence to adulthood, the boy comes to a better understanding of both himself and the world around him, and then he wonders where he will go from here. Yeah, that's the thing. It's a horrible, horrible time if you're going through a breakup, especially if you've, you know, you were in love with a person and, you know, you see that love ending. It's just never a good feeling. And it always feels like it's the end of the world. And you're pretty irrational about things. I think everybody is. I don't think it's just boys. I mean, obviously, no, women get irrational about the stuff too. I think everybody. It's just a, it's a human characteristic for that to happen, especially if it's, if it comes on sudden or you don't see it happening. But the moral of the story here is, you know, time heals all wounds. And if you're dealing with something like that now, or you think you'll be dealing with like something like that in the future, and you're not sure how you're going to handle it, there's really nothing anybody can do for you. You really just have to kind of get out of that funk yourself. And the only way it gets better is with time. That's, at least for me, that's the only way it ever helped, was after months or years or whatever, like I finally was like, all right, I'm ready to move on. And once you do move on, you know, I'm going to correlate back to what they were saying here about the album. You do, you wonder what's next. And then you have this newfound excitement for life as well. You know, even though your life was upended and you just threw a wrench into all of your plans, there is a sense of excitement you do get about, hey, well then what is next? You know, am I going to meet somebody else? Am I just going to stay single for a while? Am I just going to do my own thing? You know, and you start to look at the positives of the relationship ending, you know, like, you know, I don't have to come home at a certain time, or I can just go out and hang out with my friends, or whatever the case may be, even if you don't feel like it right away. Anyway, so we got this whole playlist here. Let's see what they got to say about the playlist. While we have made every effort to check the lyrics, it is possible some of the lyrics and videos could be incorrect. We apologize for any mistranslations. That's totally fine. I'll probably end up releasing some version of this stream on YouTube. Like I said, definitely on Patreon. So if you guys do see any misread lyrics or misinterpretations or whatever, please let me know. I would really appreciate it. All right. You guys ready? I'm ready. Let's talk about the first song here. Opening sequence ends at 3:04. This intro to the album starts on a dark note with a boy pleading for his love to stay, but that his love has already left. The boy knows, but is in denial and experiencing flashbacks from the breakup and play over and over in his head again and again like a movie. Oh my God, it's funny how that actually happens. Somebody hurt these boys. All right, let's go to the playlist here. Nope, it's this one here. These will be all the things we'll be watching today. All right, opening sequence. All right, they don't want me to post anywhere without credit, so I'm gonna give credit to Random K down over here. He's responsible for this.
Can't
door, so I'm stuck. Is your blame on me, blame on me, blame on me. No, I'm the tragedy, tragedy, tragedy. Got to get super me, super me, super me. Make all the point is in your cotton goose sequence. Stay for me, stay for me, stay for me. I can't get used to it, used to it, used to it. Yeah, this is one of the more interesting lyric videos. Okay, so I think it's ending right here. Yeah, I think this is where it's supposed to end. This is just breaking it down by whatever. Yeah, this is definitely one of the more interesting lyric videos I've ever seen. Like, they really broke everything down. Let me bring us back here for a second. I was just trying to read these and just kind of get an idea of, obviously, the guys' names. I guess that's the first step of learning about TXT is what I call these guys. And yeah, I'm not going to be able to pronounce any of this. I'll try. I'm going to call Taihun up here. He had a fantastic voice. Soban, I really enjoyed him as well. This, I can't say his name, Yuni or whatever, Yoon something. He was interesting as well. Great tonal changes in this band. It seemed like they have a decent vocal range amongst all of them. Pretty cool writing style here as well. I see what you mean by how it started off on a darker note. And I love the build of this song. I like the trail off melodies. I love the beautiful falsettos. And I also really appreciate and enjoy the electronic distorted kind of guitar sound in the back. It kind of gave us more of like an alternative rock feel. Even though this was, you know, pretty and it felt kind of dancey, mostly due to the vocals, because, you know, the production was basic 4/4 for the most part. It still made you want to move, and what made you want to kind of dance or, you know, move your shoulders or whatever, was really the walking melodies or the trail off melodies coming from the guys, especially with the falsettos here. But let's swing back around and talk about this video here. I see why this person wants credit for their lyric video. This must have taken some time. I'm gonna go ahead and subscribe right now. This is one of the more interesting ones I've seen. TXT opening sequence, line description or distribution lyrics. I like how they did this. Like, this is actually pretty cool. It reads like a text message. I can see when the guys are kind of popping up a little bit and how long they're going to be up for. This must have taken some time. All right. Nicely done. interesting way to start the album, though. Nice, cool build. I don't know. What did you guys think? I know this is a lot of you guys' first time with TXT as well. You can't help but fall for him. What do you guys think? Did you like this one? Do you think this is a cool little intro track? I personally do. I think it's a nice little intro to the album. It's your favorite song off the album? I really enjoyed it. It's a good opening. Nice. It probably reads really well live too. Yeah, it's got a great build to it. Has a nice vibe to it, yeah. Yeah, I think it's a great intro. One of your favorites? Yeah, it does. It does, Annie, doesn't it? It kind of just has, and this, I don't even know if it's actual guitar or if it's just a distorted or driven bass line in the back. But yeah, it creates some really interesting atmosphere. You wish it just had a little bit more depth there, huh? A little bit angrier, a little bit, you know, raspier, whatever. Yeah, I can see what you mean. But, you know, keep in mind, too, these guys are very young. And one of the reasons I want to do this album is because from the songs I've heard from them and what music they're putting out so far, I think they have a very interesting career ahead of them. But sometimes it just takes years to hone your skills, really years to figure out, you know, what is the best in most appropriate way to phrase what you're doing. Do you want to put a little more rasp into it? Do you want to be a little bit louder, angrier, sadder? What kind of emotion do you want to put into it? You might be one of the best singers in all the world. You know, you might, you know, have one of the most fantastic vocal talents, you know, in the world. But if you don't know how to properly express yourself or phrase yourself, that really doesn't help you all that much. And that's one of the reasons, obviously, I think BTS is such a big deal, is they very, very much know how to phrase themselves. But interesting stuff here. Interesting stuff. When I look at their view, I know maybe in another video, I'll have to go back and watch some of like their really early day stuff. I didn't realize they even had 6 albums. So if denial is the first emotion, I think this track is at least coming through the music. Yeah, it definitely does have like that denial type of feel too. It seems like, and also like a touch of pleading, you know, talking about staying with me and just dance with me and whatever. That's good. That's a good little opening track. Let's keep on moving on. I'm just gonna let this thing play out. Oh, the next one is Good Boy Gone Bad. Hold on, let me pause this. We're gonna talk about this. So this is what I saw on Live Request Wednesday, maybe a couple weeks ago. Let's see what they got to say. Good Boy Gone Bad, the official choreography version. Oh, okay, cool. All right, so this is going to be different. Good Boy Gone Bad references an earlier track, Cat and Dog, by saying, "My tail wagged at you, that's my past, and the earlier playfulness in the relationship has now turned to anger, and the boy is killing his innocence and learning from pain." Oh, boy. All right, so this is the choreography version. Thank you for finding a different version besides the music video that I already saw. Very cool, you guys. Let's see what we got here. I love this song. I don't care. It's probably great live too. The choreography is pretty cool in this one. I know what you mean by the whisper. That guy with the longer hair. He's all the way on left. He's impressive.
I like him back.
I can just call him Kai. All right, good. Thank you, yeah, I'll call him Kai. Dude, I like that a lot. Definitely a little bit darker too, them dancing in the cemetery. Cool choreography. I saw somebody pop in chat and said these guys have some of the best choreography in all of K-pop to them. Frey, exactly. Frey, you must have been here for that Live Request Wednesday I did when these guys popped up. But essentially, after hearing this song, I made a mental note saying, I got to check out this entire album. And once I put that reaction on YouTube, and I think I might have even said I want to check out the whole album, that's when all the comments said, you need to check out this whole album. It's that good. Man, what would I do if I didn't have three monitors? Nicole, I'd be interested to see your setup. I like to nerd out about people's setups. Three monitors. Impressive. exactly. I really wish I had time to watch that guide. I'm sorry about that, but by the time I get home from work, it was like 1 a.m. and I was so tired as it was, and it would have just been me staring at the computer. I don't know. hopefully in the future you can react to their art cinematic music videos. I mean, yeah, I'm thinking I possibly might spend a little more time with TXT. We'll see how the rest of this album goes, but so far it's been very, interesting. So I'd definitely like to learn more about him. I don't actually stand TXT, but I saw enough by their names and faces. I'm also a casual listener and they make good music. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know if I stand any group really. I just appreciate good music, you know? And they're writing good music and they're doing interesting stuff and they've got an interesting career. I think they got a really cool career ahead of them if they keep up at it. Yeah, so I don't know their names just yet, so bear with me as I kind of discover them through this stream here. But so far, Kai is really standing out to me. And that is not to diminish anybody else, because almost immediately after I said, oh, who's that guy with long hair, two other people popped up that also impressed me like right away too. So I guess I just got to learn who they are first. Let's not continue this little stream. That was good though. See what the next one is. All right, so this is called Trust Fund Baby. Let's see what the document has to say. So Trust Fund Baby ends at 241. Trust Fund Baby directly connects the song Loser Lover. Oh, dude, I love that one. From her last album, the lyrics love with a dollar sign from Loser Lover turn into love with no dollar signs in Trust Fund Baby. The boy in Loser Lover was a firm believer that money was all would be needed to protect his love, but unfortunately this love has failed. The boy now a cynic in bargaining with melancholy. Oh, so he's into the bargaining stage. Yeah, this is something that happens with people. I don't know if you guys ever grew up with somebody that had some money or was rich or whatever. I've encountered a couple people in my life that for whatever reason they were very wealthy for no reason of their own, and as in, like, it wasn't money they worked for, wasn't something they did, something that was inherited or given to them through whatever. I don't know if it's a trust fund or not. But that almost kind of ruins people. Yeah, I've seen people that are good people get kind of destroyed by money. And it's something that just kind of happens to people sometimes. And there's a different... When people have a lot of money, and in my day job, I work with people that have a lot of money, there's a certain air of arrogance about them. And at first I thought maybe it was just like, oh, maybe it's just me being cynical because they've got more money than I do or whatever. But no, that's not really it. People, well, at least some people that are very wealthy seem to think that, well, anything can be fixed with money because, well, most things can, you know, you throw money at it. It usually fixes the problem. Car's broken down, you know, whatever the case may be. Like, you throw money at it, the problem goes away. Except when it comes to one of the most fundamental things in life and the thing that most of us care about more than anything, and that is love. You cannot pay somebody to love you. You cannot pay somebody to stay with you, because what's more valuable than money? Time and love. And people see through that. And there's been a couple times where I've been involved with friends or people that have a lot of money where they've been completely dumbfounded that a girl left them. Yeah, I've seen this at least three times, possibly four, where like, I don't understand what her problem is. Doesn't she understand like what kind of life I can provide for her? And don't she understand like the all the money and like whatever? And I'm just kind of standing and sitting there, and I've been through these conversations where they're kind of like thinking out loud, and I'm just like thinking the entire way. I'm like, no wonder this girl left you. Like, who they don't, at a certain point, money doesn't really matter. You know, I mean, it always matters, you know, if you don't have money. But at a certain point, you realize, well, my time is worth more than this money. And if I'm going to devote myself to this person who I don't like just because they have money, it's really just robbing myself, because you're robbing yourself of that experience of having true, actual love, connecting with somebody else on like an emotional and spiritual level. Like, if you devote yourself to just that piece of paper, you're never going to have that. And you're really missing out if you don't. So anyway, these conversations were very interesting and almost kind of aggravated me at first, because I was just like, the balls on you, dude. The balls on you. Like, I was just like, it just, I don't know. Money just ruins some people. Anyway, I don't know why I was going to that fund. Oh, because it's called Trust Fund Baby. Yeah. So yeah. But in the back of my mind, I was always like, good for you, girl. Like, I was like, fuck yeah, go out, find somebody you love, find true happiness, you know? Like, yeah, this guy's gonna have a nicer house and a nicer car and everything, but you're gonna be all right. It's going to be fine. And you're going to be so much happier if you have somebody that actually appreciates you for you and you're not just some prize on their arm, which in a lot of cases this was. You know, I think they were just so used to kind of girls or like the gold digger girls, like always being kind of around them and trying to come up to them. Cause I saw like the, you know, the cars and when we go out to bars, like the over the top gaudy jewelry and shit. It was fine with me, but like I noticed, I'm like, hey, why are no girls coming up to me and talking to me? It's like, well, it's because I look like a regular dude and I don't have millions of dollars. But like I could see through the superficialness of it. I'm like, oh, okay. Like I see this. Like they're doing this for this. Which I don't know, was kind of funny to me. Anyway, that was a tangent. Let's watch Trust My Baby. Oh, this is another one from that random K dude. This is gonna be good. Hold on a second. I want to read some of these comments here. Olivia said, I had someone who was shocked because I wasn't interested with his money. Like, if I was a rich man and I was a single man, like, that's what I'd be looking for. It's like, you know, I would not be wearing Rolexes. I wouldn't make it seem like I had money. I would buy a Honda Civic. You know, I'd wear the same clothes I wear right now. I wouldn't even change my wardrobe. Even if I had millions of dollars, I'd still wear this. But it was crazy to me. It's crazy to me when they get upset when the girls don't like fall over themselves because they have money. And it's like, are they not capable of earning their own money? Who's to say that she's not going to be a millionaire someday? And then she's gonna be stuck with you anyway. Oh, man, it's just gross to me. 원하면 뭐든 지킬 수 있겠지 나와 다른 이 그게 한 평의 방이 됐든 꿈이 됐든 사랑이든 I can be a lover 이 새끼 charge a bit too much might lose again 이 game I'll never be a trust fund baby no That was actually beautiful. That's definitely the most vocally driven song I've heard so far. Something a little bit softer. I love the trail off melodies. And I also like everybody's kind of breathier voice in this one as well. It feels nice. It feels sweet. It also feels a little somber. It feels honest, you know. Trust some baby. Apparently the guys have probably run into people that are over the top rich too, you know. I mean, it's got to suck for those people too that are just that rich. Like, I know, let's not pity the rich people, but like, it's got to kind of suck for them too. You never know who really likes you for you, who's doing what for whatever. I don't know. I would imagine it'd be difficult. It doesn't happen in reverse though. Like, I don't think like, or maybe it does. I don't know. I guess you could have a sugar mama. I don't know. It's never happened to me at least. I don't know. It's crazy. Yeah, it's nice. It's got a good mood to it. It's sweet. It's soft. It's delicate. It's great because I'm starting to see the guys kind of open up vocally here as well. Everything I've heard from so far has been really punchy and kind of upbeat. And, you know, it's had some certain attitude to it. And this here is kind of, they're showing up the fact that they're gonna have some really nice soft cleans. And they did it really well. Yeah, not bad. Yeah, not bad. Let's continue. Well, this person like breaks it down by like how many, like, this person loves charts. All right, what's next? We are on, okay, we're on Lonely Boy, Tattoo on My Ring Finger. The song title is a nod to TXT's habit of long song titles from previous albums. The boy is now depressed and regretting everything after the breakup. He believes that his loss will cause him to remain alone forever. Matching couple tattoos become a metaphor of how many memories can also be permanent methods of failed relationships. Oh my God. You guys ever meet somebody with a matching tattoo? Oh boy. Yeah, it's almost like, I'm pretty good friends with my tattoo artist, and he says he won't even do them anymore. He's been doing tattoos for like 20 odd years. He owns a shop, and he's like, yeah, man. He's like, it's like almost a bad omen. It's like, it's a bad luck. It's like, as soon as you start doing like any kind of like matching, like if putting a name on your arm, like vice versa, them doing that, it's like, it's almost like the kiss of death for whatever reason. He said it's ruined so many relationships, and something about that, he said, just in his opinion, like, it just never works out. So that's why he doesn't really do that anymore. But he'll do other things. Like, my wife and I, we have somewhat similar matching tattoos, not like with names or dates or numbers or anything like that. But we use like each other's birthstones in the colors of our tattoos, pretty often. So it's like, and I've never told anybody that. I don't think she's ever told anybody that except for you guys right now. And it's just like little things. She just got my birthstone with some of the colors in her tattoos, and I got hers in mine. And that's kind of like our subtle nod to our bond, without having it be like me putting crystal across my chest or whatever, you know, not thinking that we're ever going to break up or get divorced or anything. I hope not. But we didn't want to fall and get that kiss of death, as my tattoo artist friend said. Apparently they had long song names or something. Yeah, I guess. But man, I don't know if you guys have ever been through a breakup, but yeah, once you become in that depressed stage, you think like your life is over. All of your plans are completely gone. You have no idea what you're going to do, how you're going to survive, how you're going to go on. But like I said, time heals all those wounds. Let's check it out. You don't have matching tattoos with my wife? No. And I would love to have matching tattoos with my wife, but it wasn't until I had the conversation with my tattoo artist that he said it's basically the kiss of death. He's like, it's like a curse almost, at least for him with doing it. So we're like, okay, we just won't do that. I don't think we were planning on doing it anyway. She said she'd do it. She said she'd put my name on her somewhere. But I don't feel right about that anyway. I don't feel right about my name being on somebody else's body. I just feel like, would I own you? What is this? Is it property of Jim? No. It's not my style. Yeah, they're a jinx. At least that's what he told me. I thought they're kind of cool looking. You know? Rings before marriage? Well, they have promise rings. They got promise rings, which we never had promise rings. We were together a couple years before we got married, and I didn't have much money, and that's kind of what was holding me back from asking her to marry me. I was like, oh man, like I feel like, you know, my music days are behind me. Those royalty checks stopped coming in a while ago. What am I doing with my life? And she was with me every step of the way. She really didn't care anyway. In fact, she hated it when I went on tour, which I understand. She didn't want me gone for like 6 months at a time. And so I think she actually preferred it when I stopped doing it, honestly, because I had more time for her. But I was always really worried. I'm like, oh man, if we get married now, I can't afford a house. Like, we're barely scraping by off of like just these whatever jobs I can take to figure out what I want to do with my life. But it never really seemed to matter to her. And that was always something that like really drew me into that relationship, because some people are drawn to money, you know, like you have the gold diggers and whatnot, but there's also a different crowd of both women and men. They're just drawn into performers. You know, like, I don't want to say groupies or anything like that, but like after a show or something like that, if I was in the crowd or any of my people were in the crowd, like people would come up and talk and do whatever. And again, it kind of felt like, I don't know. It's not quite money, because even I didn't really have a whole lot of money then either, but people are still drawn to performers, which in a way almost felt disingenuous too, because I'd just be like trying to grab a beer and just kind of unwind before we moved on. And I'm like, oh, why is this person talking to me or flirting with me or doing whatever? And I thought to myself, I'm like, oh, well, they wouldn't be flirting with me if they didn't just see me on stage, if I was just a regular person in the crowd. So that interaction in itself almost felt disingenuous. That's why I've never dated a fan, ever. My wife didn't seem to care, which was great. Anyway, I don't know why I'm talking about all this personal stuff. Let's keep going. This is TXT Lonely Boy, the karaoke version or whatever. All right. This person really wants her credit. I mean, it is one of the coolest like lyric videos I've seen, so I get it. So what do I call him? Hung? Hyang? Hyang Kai? Oh, I call him Kai. Yeah, this is my guy Kai, who I like. Fun bass line. Yeah, no, that was nice. Soft, sweet. I love the acoustic guitar in that one. It's great to have that organic element kind of added into that very synthetic, kind of fun, pulsating bass line, which I saw somebody in chat said kind of has an R&B type of feel to it. Yeah, it definitely does. But, you know, having the root notes come from the acoustic guitar like that, the little stabs of it, if you were to speed that up, believe it or not, you'd be listening to a reggae tune. Yeah. It's kind of like slowed down. I could remix it or re-put it together and show you. I don't have my software right now, but I could do it someday if anybody wants. But yeah, no, interesting stuff. Vocals are really good too. I like hearing another soft one from them. Interesting and somewhat creative production elements and sound design too. But yeah, the vocals are starting to steal a show here for me a while. This is what I was kind of hoping to get into. After hearing, you know, Good Boy Gone Bad and The Loser Lover and all that stuff, like I said, it all has this punch to it and this kind of almost like alternative rock feel, which it fascinates me for sure. But I'm glad that I get to hear kind of this side of them as well. Yeah, definitely gives off that depressed kind of vibe, you know. I also like the faint whistle they have in the background. It might not be a whistle. It's probably just somebody doing a falsetto and the frequency's turned up. But yeah, not bad. Lonely Boy. Let's go back to the thing here. Let's see what this next one's about. Okay, so Thursday's Child Has Gone Far to Go. All right, so this is the album title here. A subnit song with Taehyun, Boomang, and Sobin, an 80s synth pop. What? Bio Jim, or however you say that guy's name. Oh, here we go. Look, there's pictures of him. So this guy here. Yeah, these guys are adorable too. All right. All right, what am I reading here? Ends the album on a positive note. The boy is able to accept a heartbreak and move on while focusing on his own growth as Thursday's child. The boy recognizes that he has far to go in both maturing and potential. Okay. All right, let's check it out. This is definitely the most creative lyric video I've seen to date. That's an old photo. They look super young in it. Oh, I'm going to butcher names. I always do. I'm bad at talking. I should not have a microphone. All right, here we go. All right, I'm not going to copy any of this person's stuff. It's all going to be different. Nothing is going to be used. All right. They even use the 80. All right. I don't know who said the 80s synth pop thing here, but whoever came up with that, yeah, you're absolutely right. In fact, even down to like the old Roland. God, I wish I remember the name of those electronic drums. The ones that look like it looks like big giant stop signs, the D-pads that they use. This is very 80s. It even has like that kind of like 80s new wave feel by having like that acoustic electric guitar underneath it. What a shift, huh?
Child,
이런 낭만이 날 널 다시 웃게 하는 feeling so good 불타비 taste each other 가야 할 길이 많은 I 나를 기다린 날
This might be one of my favorites. Yeah, that's. I think that might be my favorite. That might be my favorite right there. My favorites off this album are the first, the intro track, Good Boy Gone Bad, and Thursday's Child. It's a short album for sure, because I think we're going to move on to the making of or something next, and then we're going to do some live stuff and some other fun stuff, looks like. I don't think there's a bad song on this album. There's not a song that takes me out of the element of what this is. I guess my only gripe with this is that it is a shorter album, but then even that, I don't feel like it's a fair assessment because they give us so much with so little, where I feel like it kind of fits neatly into a package. Whereas if this was drawn out into like a 12 song, full length album, maybe it would have gotten a bit repetitive or a bit much or something. But I feel like they really do. They hit the five different stages pretty well right here. And it wraps up in this nice little neat package that is probably like a half hour long or something, maybe a little bit less. But overall, though, I mean, the production is really polished. There's some great vocal performances on this. It shows both their, harder, punchier style and showing some actual, interesting and unique phrasings, and at the same time they show a lot of like really nice clean softs. As far as like knowing their names and everything and all that stuff, I still don't. I like Kai. that's all I know so far, is I like him. But that's only because I haven't learned anybody else's name, and I'm sure once I go and learn that, it'll be even more intense. But I think that's the album right there. We're going to move on to some live stuff and some behind-the-scenes stuff and a bunch of other stuff the team has put together for me today. But overall, I mean, I think I saw some people say this was their first time experiencing this album. What did you guys think? Do you think this is a cool album? Do you have any gripes with it? How do you feel about the overall length of it? It's kind of bittersweet for me. I feel like I appreciate the fact that they were able to wrap up so much in a concept album in such a short format and deliver... just a polished version of every song, every step of the way. But there's still some part of me, it's like, oh, I wish it was just maybe just like three more tracks, maybe like three or four more tracks. Yeah, I mean, I really like this whole thing through and through. I really do. I mean, TXT they got an interesting career. I'm going to have my eye on these guys, and I'm just really fascinated to see like where they're going to go, what they're going to do. I had no idea that they had like five albums before this. I figured this was like their second or possibly third album or something, but maybe it's just a bunch of short albums like this. They just put it out like one every year or every 6 months or whatever they do. You really enjoying it? Yeah, it's nice, man. It's cool. I mean, it changes, song for song, like they really nail the emotion of each, emotion they're trying to hit, whether it be, anger, grief, bargaining, any stuff. I feel like they really do hit it. And I like the way that it wraps up, too. I like how it starts in a darker tone. It starts with, like, those really overdriven synthesizers and possibly guitar. And then it ends with, like, this 80s, like, synth bop thing. And they stuck true to the realm of synth bop here by using, like, the cheesy 80s, like, electronic drums and just some other fun production elements as well, with the acoustic guitar working in with the that 80s synth sound as well, which kind of gives it this... I don't know, Flock of Seagulls kind of new wave type of vibe to it, but with like a more up-tempo type of vibe. Pretty cool though. Pretty cool overall. I'm interested to see some of the recording sessions and what went into making this album. So we're going to check that out right now. They've been around for 3 years already. They're really big. Yeah, okay. So then they're what? They're putting out an album every 6 months? That's kind of cool. That's the thing. It's this whole short album concept is very new to me. And it's something I've only seen with K-pop. Like, I'm just used to albums being at least 10 tracks, you know? And I guess it's okay since they put out so much music, you know, like if you were to like think of like a band who, you know, puts out an album every 2 years or whatever, they might give you 10, 12 tracks, but that's all you get for 2 years. You know, for 2 years from a K-pop artist, you might get 4 albums and you're actually getting, you know, 20 songs in total in that same time frame that you'd only get 12 from, you know, an act that I listen to. So it is more bang for your buck. It's just it's a different formatting that I'm not used to. About 8 months. Yeah, the world tour. That's going to be awesome. Didn't Autumn Rain say she already has tickets? Yeah, do you got tickets? Yeah. That's pretty badass. The K-pop industry moves so fast, they have to keep themselves in front of fans so they don't move short formats. Yeah, and that's the thing I've just been kind of learning about, I guess. This whole thing was just, it's very different than everything I've ever listened to or been a part of with music. But the reason K-pop fascinates me is because it's so different from artist to artist. And there's no one genre to define what K-pop can be or is. And there's a lot more to it than just like cheesy throwaway music. Like there's depth, there's actual messages, there's cool concepts like on this album here. And there's tons of that stuff out there. And there's just a whole world of things for me to explore. That I'm now just finding in my 30s, you know, stuff people normally find when they're younger. I'm just finding now. And it's, man, it's been a wild ride. And I don't even know where it's going to go from here. So, guys, I think I'm going to run to the bathroom here real quick. And then we're going to move on with the stream. We got some behind-the-scenes stuff and then some live performances as well. So make sure to stick around. And I'll be back in just a minute. Be right back. My thing. It's over here.
Bye, jump to sleep.
keep flying. I'm gonna name so but don't you got it. No, I don't know if I've heard ghosting. Should I do it now? You already multi anyway, powders? That's awesome. I have yet to uncover a bad TXT song. Would I be going through all their albums? I'm thinking I might, honestly. I'm definitely going to be watching more behind-the-scenes stuff with these guys. I'm definitely going to be watching more stuff with TXT, because from this point on, I really want to follow their career a little bit more intensely, because I think they're really destined for great things, and they've been putting out a ton of fantastic music. But yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. Loser Lover. I think that was my first song I heard from them, I believe. And then maybe one or two other ones. Let's see here. It's a good time to start now. Yeah, exactly. I can probably just like catch up pretty quick. So we'll see. I kind of got a lot on my plate right now with a bunch of other stuff I'm doing. But TXT is definitely on my radar for sure. And yeah. So multi, that just means like you're into multiple different groups and such, which I know is like a whole different style of fandom, you know, like BTS is its own thing, you know, and then keeping up with that, with the Weverse and all of the content and stuff, like it's a lot of stuff to keep up with and explore, which is great. It's great for us as fans, but it's very time consuming. So you just don't have time to be into multiple groups, I guess. Yeah, I get it. I'm just trying to figure out basically what groups I do like. And, you know, obviously TXT's in the docket, and Hyphen's another one I've been interested in. They're younger guys as well. Stray Kids, they seem like something I want to check out more as well. As far as like this new generation of K-pop or newer, I'm not sure what generation we're in right now. But then I also want to swing back around and check out, like, you know, a lot of like where this began. And that's, you know, almost more important to me right now is learning about like the history of K-pop and how this whole thing started and just some of the pioneers in this genre. And that's why I've been lucky enough to have a lot of cool people recommend some music from some of like the earlier days of K-pop. And to me, it's kind of cool just to see the evolution and see how far things have gotten and where they have gone, because it's its own unique thing. And it's very fascinating to explore. We're in fourth gen right now. Join us. You can do it. yeah, Stray Kids is good, too. I'd love to do a Stray Kids album reaction. Same thing with Hyphen. Those guys are awesome. Those are the ones I'm kind of interested with. Everyone keeps talking about 17. I've heard a song or two from them. And I don't know. Maybe it's not clicking with me. It's not that I don't like it. It's just I feel like I'm more fascinated with like the three groups I just mentioned. But I could check out 17 as well. I just can't promise I'm going to like it. The history is really interesting, right? Yeah, and that's the thing. Atiz, Big Bang, Shiny, all of these artists. Like, trust me, I want to swing back around to them and I want to explore more of their stuff because, yeah. Was it Big Bang's another one? G-Idol, there's so many that I want to go into, and my favorite way of doing this is album reactions because I get to explore a lot of stuff all at once. But anyway, let's get back to the show here. There's so many good groups, and like there's new ones all the time, and then there's new ones too that are popping off like every day. That you know, since the industry moves so fast, there's always tons of stuff. In fact, in our Discord, I asked people to start sharing new music with me. And if you guys want to share new or upcoming artists or anything I should kind of keep my eye on, you can pop into our Discord and you can check it out. I've already got like 13 or 14 different links in there. And then the next time I have time, I'm just going to go through all of them and just get them all on YouTube and just explore some of the new music that's out there right now. All right, let's see here. Let's go back to the docket. Let's see what's next. All right. So we got the behind the scenes we're going to watch right now. Okay, that's all the information I have. That's all the information I need. Oh, boy. Actually, I have to go back and click the link again. Oop. I have to go to Discord and do that. Because I lost it. YouTube playlist. Yep. So we are down to... Here we go. This is the Minisode 2 Thursday's Child recording and behind the scenes.
Good boy, good bad.
Yeah, me too, buddy.
Good boy, come back.
This part he's talking about right here is what's known off as a trail off melody. Why this guy is struggling right now is because with these trail off melodies, essentially what you're doing is you're playing a scale on top of basically a melody structure that's already there. So he's going, good boy, come bad, good boy, come bad, good boy, come bad. So it sounds like the notes are kind of going down, but he has to put different emphasis on different versions of the enunciation. So put more emphasis on the G, on the B, and even though it's a scale going down, the higher notes are going up. So it's got this crossfade kind of melody thing going on. But he's also, what it seems like he's struggling with here is he's trying to figure out ways to put the emphasis on the G and the B, especially while the rest of the melody is going up, but he's trying to kind of take it back down for that crossfade.
Boy, come back.
You can do it, buddy. You can do it. Oh, that's a good point too, also because it's English. No, I'm not even thinking about that. Also, yeah, it's in a different language for the guy. So finding like the right enunciation and the right letters to put that phrasing on, to put that sustain or just like, you know, drive or anything into, to change that scale in a different language is also probably very difficult as well. I've never recorded anything in a different language, so I don't even know about that. He's getting tongue-tied.
두 개씩 해도 돼요? 저 진짜 혀가 너무 꼬여가지고.
Yeah, there it is.
Good boy, come back. 아우, 미치겠다. 진짜 래퍼였으면 큰일 났을 뻔했네.
제가 그 이 헤드셋을 이렇게 해서 왼쪽에만 끼고 있어서 그냥 다 왼쪽으로만 주시면 될 것 같아요.
Born to be Thursday's child, 가야 할 길이 많은 아이, 나를 기다릴 날들과 달에 맞추려고.
막주 다시 받을게요.
Choice,
들으면서 한번 할게요. 데모 들으면서. 네.
Yeah, he sounds great clean. They don't put too many effects in their vocals anyway, just some minor compression. Which is great, because what you hear is what you get.
I did it. Oh. Oh. The coupling is really hard. Oh. Yeah. Melody is something. I wrote it from the beginning to the end. ANR도 그래도 프리코러스가 들어갔어요. 벌스랑 싸움이 남게 들어가고. 근데 일부 인정합니다. 왜냐면은 벌스 같은 거는 다 잘 썼어요. 다 좋았고 그래서 할 말이 없었는데 하지만 뭐 경력직들과 붙어서 이 정도 아웃풋을 낸 것만으로도 만족스럽다고 하려고 했는데 저도 안 들어가는 것보단 희망적이었다.
네. 날 다시 걷게 하네. 눈에 띄어 요즘 뜨는 트렌드가.
발음이 되게 좋네요. 혀가 얇은 건지 아니면 뭐 되게 빠른 건지 이게 어떻게 이렇게 해시태그 이렇게 어떻게 되지? 전 이게 안 되는데 서울 사람이라 그런가? 이상하네.
오늘의 해시 오늘의 오늘의 해시태그 브레이크.
미치겠다. 영어를 왜 세 개를 연달아 붙여놨대요. 해시태그 브레이크업. 네, 해보겠습니다.
오늘의
미스테이크 미스테이크.
오늘의 해시태그 브레이크업.
이거 봐, 더 굴릴 순 없는데요. 브레이크업 이렇게 할까요? 해시태그 이렇게 할거야. Break up like this. Okay. 무슨 말씀이세요? 한번 틀어주세요.
I wonder how old these guys are.
애리잖아요, 누가 들어도. 해외 살다 오셨어요? Okay.
They're young, in their 20s. Okay. That's what I would have guessed. They're kind of like in their 20s.
Hold on, hold on.
Hold on, hold on.
Hold on, hold on. Hold on,
hold on. 그렇게 이제 그 마인드맵처럼 이렇게 그냥 주제를 하나 해놓고 이렇게 계속 나뭇가지 치기를 했었는데 이제는 약간 그냥 뭐 스토리처럼 그냥 이렇게 처음부터 끝까지 그냥, 내 머릿속에서 상황에서 그 주인공의 첫 이야기부터 그냥 막 마지막까지 써본다거나 그냥 스토리 하나 쓰고 그 중에서 그냥 그럴싸한 거 발췌해서 이렇게 좀 가사 형식으로 만든 그런 식으로 한 것 같은데.
Interesting. It's an interesting approach.
네.
더블링이랑
네.
코러스들 녹음할 거야.
네.
좀 한번 들어보자. 원래 거?
네.
어떻게 되는지?
싫어 이제 아는 일에 맞지 않은 이유적이 세기에 없나.
화음이 있거든?
아. 싫어 이제 아는 일에 싫어 이제 아는 일에 맞지 않은 이유적이 Goodbye, gone bad.
많이 씹어서요. 다 내다 버려. 다 내다 버려. Goodbye, gone bad. 다 내다 버려. 이 사비 가사 뒤에 다 버려 널 사랑했던 여기 바뀐 거예요. 중간 것도 바뀌었네요. 아이고야.
아, 아직 본능 환자 없어요.
아, 그래요. 아, 다행이다. 아, 스케. 건벨. 건벨. 좀 두껍게 낼까요? 네. 건벨. 피 대신 흘러 모노크롬 다이아몬드. 피님. 그리고 모노크롬 다이아몬드 할 때 한 미 하나 위로해서 모노크롬 다이아몬드 약간 이런 식으로 하면 어떨 것 같으세요? 네. Monochrome diamonds. 수고했습니다. 아, 힘들어.
네. Day 2 of recording. All right.
화이팅.
뭐야? 그래, 화이팅.
내가 해봤거든? 어. 너 이제 피투한다.
불안한데. 네. 잘 부탁드립니다.
네. 타다다다다. 네.
차! 짜내나 버려! Yeah, he looks mean, right?
단, 아, 네. 차내다 버려!
네. Gone bad. 네. 아, 네. Gone bad. 네.
똑같다.
어. 다내다 버려 그 boy. Gone bad. 날 사랑했던 그 boy. Gone bad. 어, 예. 고생하셨습니다.
But he didn't do it. I wanted to hear his bad.
안녕하세요. 잘 지내셨어요? 되게 좀 자주 뵙는 것 같은데요. 이틀 동안 네 번 봤네요.
이제 여기 음정만 맞추면 되겠다. 와우. 태연이 이거 Born to be Thirsty Child 가열길이 많으나 이거 다 한 큐로 불렀어요.
메인은 끊어서 했고.
네.
더블링은 한 큐 했던 것 같아요.
이 녀석 보소. 이거 어떻게 한 큐에 불렀지? 아, 오케이 해보겠습니다. 10초만 있다가. 어, 어지럽지 왜? 오케이 하겠습니다. Born to be thirsty child 가야 할 길이 많은 너 다시 늦지 않을래 네,
한번 들어보고 있습니다.
어지러워.
Thirsty child만 조금만 더 힘...
I think he's dizzy because he's doing it more breathy. And when you do that, you're obviously less oxygen to your brain. That's what I think is happening right here. I'm telling you guys, give it a couple more years with these guys and they're going to be flying through these sessions in the studio. But this is so interesting to kind of see the early years with these guys. I know they've been around for like 3 years, but you need give these guys 5-10 years in this studio and things are going to get really good. I know it seems far off, but just trust me.
Thursday child. 네.
These little hiccups will be so quick to fix.
한 번만 다시 해보겠습니다. 한 번 다시 해볼게요.
Because to him, it's like blowing up like a balloon, you know, that makes you like dizzy. That's what's happening. 3 years. Yeah, I'm going to want to go back and listen to some of their earlier stuff and just see for myself.
잠시만요. 아! 아! 오케이, 마음의 준비가 됐어요. 술 같아요, 술! 가 운명을 마주해 목요일에 아이랑 나만이 날 날 다시 다시 할게요.
네, 다 했습니다.
네, 고생하셨습니다.
네.
오케이! 힘들었어요. 그쵸? 힘들었어요. 끝나지 않는 미로에 갇힌 듯한 느낌이 너무 힘들었어요. 그래도 이제 많이 했습니다.
Are they good guys?
굉장히 빠르게.
Are they good guys? They had a good relationship with the staff? 네.
바름만.
바름이요?
Look at this turtleneck.
단지 외롭게 좀 없어. 여기만.
많은데요?
Where do you even buy something like that? 너는 건 남긴 흔적마저
lonely.
살살살 Are they really?
괜찮아요?
어. Well, that's good to know.
반지를 대신에 자리에 앉자구. 반지를 대신에 자리에 앉자구. 반지를 대신에 자리.
남긴 흔적마저 lonely. 날카로운 바늘로 찍어 남긴 건 손가락. 지금 반지로 들려?
아니요, 그냥 거기 한번.
He's getting a ring to it because it's like having like P's and S's, and when you're doing audio recording like that, like that's why they have a little, you know, the mic filter pop and stuff like that. But still, since it's a higher frequency or higher note, it comes across and it punches through the melody, and it just might seem like it's a little divided than anything else would be. That's the issue that's happening right now.
반지.
반. You got it, buddy. I believe in you. 반지를, I got him.
호흡으로 그냥 반지를. 반지를 드시는. 오 좋다. 반지를 드시는 자리 한 장. 이것도 괜찮아.
들어가자.
Yeah, yeah. 얘가 딱히 막 음이 막 있고 이런 건 아니죠?
네.
There's no particular key.
얘는 몇 개 더 해볼게요.
Okay, he's just putting the accents on. Okay, I thought he was gonna actually evoke double up his vocaling here. And I'm like, there's 100% a key.
날 다시 걷게 하는 그 속은 본투미. 네, 이거 들으면서 이거 위에 갈게요. 번개 걸로 그럼 밑에다 틀어주세요. 네. 이거 대만만 들어볼게요. 근데 약간 되게 흐르는 것 같은데.
양수를 좀 다르게 가져왔어요. 저렇게 하면
좀 너무. Yeah, it's a cool audio effect.
조금만 더 씹어서.
네. 근데 네. 요 아이란까지는 괜찮은 것 같은데 네. 운명이 날 이렇게 하는 게 약간 뭔가 그 이게 얘가. 제 그룹을 살려서 불러줬는데 겨울에 아이란 운명이 이렇게 하니까 엇박으로 이 액센트가 찍히면서
그냥 여기는 발음으로 좀 처리하면 될 것 같아요.
네. 고생하셨습니다.
한 50% 남았어요. 반 했는데 원래 시작이 제일 어렵거든요. 근데 지금 생각보다 우려했던 것보다는 잘 나오고 있는 것 같습니다. 우려를 많이 했거든요. 근데 다행입니다. 가끔 우려를 넘어서는 친구들이 있는데 그러진 않았어요. 아직은.
다시 또 들어가야 해요. 다른 노래로.
한 번만.
어때? Thursday 목요일에 한 세 번만 연속으로 해볼 수 있나요? 그러면? 많이 될걸 seven days. It's Thursday. 목요일. Thursday. It's Thursday. 목요일에.
지금은 Thursday로 바로 들어가는 것 같은데.
It's Thursday. Thursday. Thursday.
네.
더 이상 떠나온 슬픔이 너머에 설렘만 가득 채워지게.
태연이가 한 거 한 번만 다시 들어볼 수 있을 거야.
네.
기운은 내 일요일 하루 더 있잖아.
이제부터가 시작이야. 나를 기. Is this Sobin here? Is that his name? I like him.
말고 아득한 어딘가 다시.
네.
네. Okay, so they got leaders too. Sobin. I'm probably still saying it wrong. Okay, I didn't realize they had leaders as well, so I guess he's the leader here. Oh, Sobin. Is a soup called Sobin? Yeah, we'll call him Sobin. Sobin. Anyway, I like him. I like his style. I like his voice. And now I'm just learning he's the actual leader of this group.
Oh, good.
Wait, no, not Bean? No, not Bean? Sobi? Zubin? Zubin? Subin. Is it Subin? Zubin. Is it Zubin? I think we get Zubin. We've landed on Zubin. Okay. No Z? Can I just give him a nickname? Can I just give him a nickname? Does he have a nickname? No, I can't. Cabbage says no. All right. Damn it. So I just can't call him Fred then. It'd be bad if I called him Fred. Subin. Bobutt? all right. Well, this will take forever. Let's just continue. I just won't say their names until I get like... I'll have to put it into like a word thing where I hear how their names are said.
친가요? 와, 고맙습니다. 고맙습니다. 고맙습니다.
사실 어제랑 그저께는 제가 보컬 레슨을 받다가 받자마자 바로 와갖고 요즘 보컬 레슨에서 제가 음역대 늘리는 연습을 하고 있거든요.
Wait, they already have English names? Tell me now! It'll make things so much easier for me. Ben and Zoo. Is Ben, I don't know. Well, I'll get to that later. We'll get to that later. This is gonna be a whole thing.
너덜너덜한 상태로 오니까 너무 힘들어갖고 좀 솔직히 잘 못 나온 것 같아서 많이 아쉬웠는데 오늘은 그래도 오늘은 어느 정도 한 것 같습니다. 다행히 아직 앞으로 녹음할 날 좀 많이 남아있으니까 더 멋있게 불러보도록 하겠습니다. 오늘 먼저 퇴근할게요. 안녕.
네, 오늘의 녹음 이렇게 끝났습니다. 오늘은 저 트러스트 펀드 베이비 좀 우리가 쉽지 않아갖고 어제 만들어 놓은 사비에다가 메인을 수정하고 코러스를 받고 수빈이 형이 더블링을 쳐주고 지금
수빈.
마지막 멘트를 찍고 있는데 이렇게
멀쩡한
목소리를 나갈 수 있는 거는 그날 녹음이 상당히 괜찮았던 거예요.
고생하셨습니다.
야, yeah, I'm just gonna have to hear the names. I'll put it into a, like a I don't know, let's look on YouTube or something. Next stream, I'll know how to pronounce their names.
안녕하세요.
프리코러스가 화음이 많더라고요.
You were struggling the first two? Okay, that makes me feel a little better. I just want to know their names. That's all.
한심했던 날들보다 한심했던 날들보다
He's got a really cool choir effect on his voice here.
Oh,
I love his voice. Yeah, he's got some unique vocals. Whoever this guy is. It's not just the audio effects and the doubling that they're putting on it, that choir effect. He sounds good clean. Hold on a second. Bear with me here. I want to see a couple things. Yeah, it's just a bunch of layering.
Yes.
오 역시 태연이 우리
고생하셨습니다.
네, 고생하셨습니다.
Yeah, great use of layering, cool choir effect.
하나씩 들으니까 크게 와다.
It's great because it gives us like. It gives us the highs and it gives us like kind of the, he basically works as what I think he works as the baritone in the group. But he's able to switch up the frequencies and his keys to go into that falsetto range just slightly. And by adding that doubling effect and the choiring effect, it just gives us this really kind of like, I don't know, this really kind of cool space to work with, especially for this like pre-verse or this, I guess someone call it a pre-verse. Or pre-chorus rather, I'm sorry.
뭐랄까 공포스러운 화음이라고 해야 되나 그런 약간 거미가 튀어나올 것 같은 그런 화음이 있거든요 이렇게 화음이 촥 퍼지는 이런 그런 화음이 아니에요 이건 약간 화음이 스멀스멀 침입하는 느낌 뭔지 아시죠?
He's trying to say it. He's saying what I'm saying, but like his own version of it. Yeah, I guess it would be considered spooky, just from having like that kind of that atmosphere to it, the vibe of it. But yeah, they're totally using. I forget the exact name of the effect, but it's a choir effect, and it's a doubling as well, which is just you know he's saying it once and then saying it twice and then just in slightly different keys, which just emphasizes that choir effect even just a little bit more. But yeah, I guess it is a little spooky. The hell is happening? Oh, this is the fatigue you never see. Awesome texture on the drums here too, by the way. These ad libs are really fun right here.
I was
going to do the accent melody. That's a sign of frustration.
Yeah.
He's probably driving the producers nuts by crinkling that paper like that. Because it picks up. That's why they come in and they take their jackets off and everything, because they're rubbing together. The microphone picks that up and then you have this static effect. The same thing happens when you're twisting and pulling apart paper. This is the fatigue you never get to see from the behind the scenes stuff. All right, so we're on the last day of recording here. Let's see how they wrap it all up.
Yeah,
You sounded too sweet. We need more attitude, man. Give us more attitude. It's gonna shift your tone a bit, buddy.
Ah, 너무 귀엽네.
준비 됐지?
네. All right, let's see what we're working with here. Hold on a second.
에너지 있게 높게.
아, 너무 귀엽네.
기 미 원 세컨드.
'Cause there, music is just a full.
Oh, I see what's happening here. I see what's happening. So, the music itself, the tracks of the instruments and stuff like that, are already on one track somewhere else, which we're not seeing on this little thing here. So the guys are. They're fundamentally tied to whatever key and whatever instrument is in place, unless they go back and re-edit it out. But I'm assuming since they're trying to get this done in 3 days, the production has already been done on it, and now they're just coming in and they're just doing the vocals on it. But it doesn't seem like they have the ability, unless they've got a totally different track list over here, which would be, this is kind of a strange way to do this, with every individual click and hitting everything out, because if they're expressing stuff, they want to change their key or just like mess with the frequency in any way, shape, or form, or even just like add effects or something. You really want to be able to take an instrument in or out or add a certain effect on that instrument to correlate with the vocals. So it seems like they're really tied down to the track. Like once the track is done, the track is done. At least that's everything I'm seeing as far as like when they ever zoom in on, I'm assuming they're using Logic or some kind of variation of Pro Tools, but it's probably Logic. It's called DAW, which is a digital audio workstation. Yeah, interesting, but it kind of limits them a little bit.
준비 됐지?
네.
에너지 있게 높게 해야 돼요.
Because if they could break it down track by track, instrument by instrument, they'd have a lot more freedom.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
듣고 이렇게 여섯 개.
This is also a cool way to do gang vocals. Gang vocals are just called like when they come in and they do stuff together, like these, like what you're seeing right now. But what you're seeing here is we have two different microphones on a different axis, and the microphones are known as what's called omnidirectional, which means basically like this microphone here, like I talk in here and you can hear it, but if I talk in here, you can't really hear it. So like my audio source needs to come in like a cone, all right, if you want to hear my voice correctly. What they're doing is they're using a microphone that can record from two different sides. So the back side over here and that side. So it's picking up all the different audio in the room. Also, I'm not sure what this microphone is up over here, but I can almost guarantee they're both omnidirectional. But by both having them layered like that, you're able to kind of have this natural effect of reverb without actually having an effect on there. And when you put an effect on something, anything, whether that be drive, distortion, reverb, delay, anything, whenever you put an effect in audio, essentially what you're doing is you're degrading that audio sample, the wave file of that audio form. So you don't want to add and layer too many different effects on it because it loses its oomph, it loses its clean audio signal. So this is kind of a cool way to do it. I don't think I've ever seen it done twice like this in a solid recording booth like this with both omnidirectional mics, but it's a very smart audio solution.
계속 틀어주시면 저희 그 마디마다 할까요? 워워워워 당당당당 워워워워
아니야 아니야 자꾸 늦게 타는데 다시 할게요.
네.
Because also look how far apart the guys are. Like when you're just hearing this guy kind of talk and everything, like he still had some basic clarity to his voice, but it wasn't like how this guy or this guy was talking, how clear it was. And that's just because he's further back from the mic. And when you do that as well, you need to change the signal. I can kind of show you on this. So like on the back of this microphone, let me bring it right up over here, you have these little lines and stuff, which basically gives you how much drive you want to put into that sound. And I've just got mine flat out because I use my own filters and whatnot. But you need to have a little bit more drive, which again is going to degrade the audio signal. Oops, wrong one. But this is an interesting way to do gang vocals. both of the omnidirectionals.
한 명이 다 치겠습니다. 월을 좀 느리게.
하나 더 할게요.
네.
그럴듯해졌으니까. 여러 개 합치니까.
좋은데 옆에 있는
오랑 어사이?
피디님
저 마지막에 띡살이 난 것 같습니다.
띡살이가 아니라 감정이었어요 사실.
내보낼까요?
아니야 너 열심히 하고 있잖아.
어? 열렸다!
지금 진짜 유레카 외치고 있는 뭐야?
나 이거 지금 망가져서 안 내려갔었는데.
다시는 잠그지. Stop messing around with your zipper. It's being picked up.
유레카!
Take your jackets off, man. Yeah, they clean that up good.
I like that. Oh,
yeah. All that hard work paying off right here.
Before I get bad.
Love
you. 펄짝이다 이건.
아직 녹 밸런스는 안 만졌으긴 했는데 다 아직 하고. 수고했습니다.
고생했어.
Yeah, this isn't even in post yet, and basically it's not even mastered yet. And once it gets mastered, it's going to get compressed down. It's going to sound even better in a wider format as well. But yeah, man, this is cool. This is a cool little behind the scenes showing, you know, basically what the guys had to go into the studio and do, at least for the audio portions of the vocal portions of this album here. And there's a lot of layering going on, a lot of interesting effects, a lot of neat studio techniques, especially with the gang vocals with those omnidirectional mics. That was surprising, but I mean, it makes sense. It's a really clean way to do it. I've never recorded too many gang vocals, but I've just never done it like that. But it's a smarter way to do it than any way I've done it. Yeah, no, pretty good, pretty good. I was a little surprised that they didn't have the individual tracks where they could mess out. Like, usually when you go in, you're going to have your master track set list, which is going to be not only just your drum track, but each individual hit and their individual effect that's correlated with that. And then you can kind of really slip the vocals in and out. But hey, maybe this is something they just do after in post, where they really slip in those effects. In fact, I know that they do. It's just surprising they didn't really give the guys... at least they didn't show it on video here. They didn't give them that option to kind of like mess with those the tonal changes and whatnot. They seem to kind of have to stay pretty much by the book and not have too much, I don't want to say leeway, but not too much, you know, difference that was automatically created. And I know they've got a good, you know, at least some of them write a lot of the music themselves too. So, you know, it's the foundation and whatnot, but you kind of want to have that freedom when you're doing vocals. At least I've always wanted to have that kind of freedom. But they're dealing with, you know, different kinds of restrictions. You know, they wanted to get this done in 3 days. They probably have a crazy schedule and stuff, so like if you're day behind, like it can cost a lot of money. So I get it, you know, time is money. But that's cool. That's a little behind the scenes there. It's cool too. It showed like the actual fatigue and what it's like in a studio for days at a time. You know what I mean? Because you hear the same 3 seconds of audio 50, 60 times, and then you have to go in and do it again and again and again. By the time you finally listen to that song at the end, you're like, you're so sick of it. You're like, oh my God, I'm so sick and tired of listening to my voice. And you're second guessing yourself. And when you're in there with a bunch of guys and producers and techs and whatnot, like, you know, all eyes are on you. And when you're in there just singing, there's just, it's just your clean voice. And it just like, it's hard to see and hear the big picture. And it's nerve wracking to do that. And that's why you saw like the little tweels, the paper, the playing with the zippers and whatnot. Like, these are all just like nervous tics that like everybody has. Almost every musician I've worked with, and even myself in the studio, like, we all have our thing. It's kind of like this nervous tic. And I don't care how many people you've performed in front of, what you're doing, when it's all eyes on you and everybody's already put their part in, it's time for you to put your part in. It is one of the most nerve-wracking experiences ever. Like, I don't care who you are. And I've seen it. I've seen it with big musicians too. Bands that have been together 20 years, you know, they go into the studio and it's time to lay down their track and it's all eyes on them. And everybody's there is watching and making sure you're not going to mess it up. Like, it's nerve wracking. All right. So now we're going to move on to a couple live performances. And then we're going to finish this stream up here. Let's see here. I think what you're wondering could probably be answered if you watch the DJ Swivel videos, because you see how they laid down the tracks in DAW and details. Oh, really? Oh, well, yeah. I mean, I'm pretty much pretty sure how they do it, Miss JJ. I know there's a. I'd be interested to see some of the audio effects that they use on some of those tracks for sure. But I'm assuming they just did it this way for time management situations, you know. If they had maybe a week or 2 weeks to do it, I'm sure they would have, you know, done it a different way. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, that's the whole thing too. So we're not even talking about the choreography of these new albums and everything, and that's like a totally different thing altogether. And since this music comes out so quickly and you constantly have to be like in the eye or changing things up or doing things differently, it's just an incredible amount of stress, you know? With me, it was like when you get a band, it's like, okay, well, you know how to play the song, right? Okay, just go do that, you know? And what you do on stage is just kind of up to you. Just wing it every night. Not these guys. All right, so we got a couple more live performances, and then we're going to finish up over here. The first one we have is the opening sequence in 4K from the TXT comeback show on Thursday's Child. Let's check it out. Yeah. Ooh, ooh, ah. 해 아침부터 반대로 흐르는 화면 너와 내가 끝난 장면에서 영화 시작돼 널 따라가는 이 별의 build-up 사건이 돼 opening sequence 익숙한 이 pain 기억 속에 내가 보여 dance with me dance with me dance with me take on my chance on me chance on me chance on me I'm bleeding painfully painfully wow. painfully but it drips off no but it's just me she's so stay for me stay for me stay for me Yeah, I actually really like this choreography. It's very dramatic. Yeah, their choreography is no joke. Yeah, that was badass. Great performance right there. I think those vocals were live. I was kind of more focused on the choreography, but they sounded great. That was awesome. I love the stage design too. They really brought that like distorted synth to life there. All right, next one we got Good Boy Gone Bad. What is this? This is like a full-on story. Great video quality. This feels like a movie. They're good boys going bad. Something's up with, like, the camera here. It's, like, almost too realistic. Yeah, it's like a really nice camera. It like looks almost like too real. It's like almost too clear. The picture's almost too good. They make you a little nauseous. Yeah, it's a little strange. I know it's compressed down too for you guys watching on Twitch right now, but like, if you watch this actual video, it's kind of wild. Fast forward shots, is that what they're called?
I like them bad.
They're not saying live because it doesn't match up. Well, you know, that the thing is this camera work here and like this kind of camera, it's like in super 4K. Like, look at the settings here. This is at 2160p by 60, you know, normally it's like 1080p by 60. So the camera is just like kind of, it's like super HD. So it looks kind of weird and their movements are kind of janky. Like, it all lines up, but it's almost like too realistic. So they could be seeing live. I know some of it's at least pre-recorded. But cool performance nonetheless. Yeah. There's definitely some like backing tracks, but nothing like that stands out too much. Some like subtle layering effects, really. All right, we got trust. Well, you can read trust fund baby.
Game
I thought I recognized a note change or two in there. It's supposed to be live. Cool set, I guess. Yeah, that's the thing. It's like everything is so HD in these like videos here. Like a lot of it's got to be pre-recorded. It's just something that happens on TV and all kinds of shows. Like it's just, it happens here in America too. Some places just, it's just what they do. You know, it's just what they're trying to do, and you just don't really have any option.
Yeah,
sorry, I was just checking something else. Okay, cool. So this is, I was just seeing something in the video here. So this is Good Boy Gone Bad, the music video shoot sketch. It's just so damn catchy. Take it easy, Olivia. Thanks for hanging out for a bit.
네, 제가 두 번째 타자로 개인 촬영을 하고 있습니다. 저도 벌스를 오랜만에 처음에 맡게 되었거든요. 그래서 뮤직비디오의 시작이라는 그런 촬영을 하고 있었습니다.
제가 한 거 아닙니다.
저희가 이때까지 했던 곡들과는 느낌이 완전 많이 다르잖아요. 곡 가사만 봐도 제 벌스에서 벌써 반뚜껑이라는 단어가 나오고 막 죽여놔 막 이런 단어
많이 나와서 모아분들이 처음 들으면 조금 충격을 받을 수도 있어요.
주무실 때 포지션 이건 거.
네.
네.
신기합니다.
Stage is afraid?
생각보다 스무스해요. 뭔가 별 느낌이 안 들어요. 우와, 드디어 대신 시작이 전부 거울 봐도 되나요? 내 안에 착하던 남자는 죽었다 약간 이런 노래였고.
No, no, well, thanks for hanging out.
나쁜 남자, ST. 근데 천성이 좀 착해갖고 연기하기가 좀 어렵네요.
어떤 패치를 파나요? 화 별로 안 되죠, 맞죠?
네.
바나나 마두유를 누가 두 개부터 먹었을 때?
하나. 네.
포켓몬도 누가 먹었을 때?
What the hell is banana milk?
아,
just like a banana smoothie?
어? 뭐야 나? 제가 1일차 촬영의 마지막 엔딩 유동을 맡았는데 너무 잘 나왔고 또 평소에 저랑 좀 다른 모습을 봤던 것 같아요. 저는 오늘 만족스럽습니다. 들어가서 쉬도록 하겠습니다. 저는 내일 좀 늦게 날 거예요, 여러분. 2일차 촬영 때 봐요.
Good boy gone bad. 우리 2일차입니다. 제가 오늘의 스타트예요. 저는 1일차 때 없었거든.
카메라는 이쪽에서 이렇게 찍을
거고. 저도 준비해온 거 같아요. 브레이셋도 이렇게 들면서 약간 달라지는 거 같아요.
Banana flavored milk?
조금 더 나아가서.
What? That's a thing?
그땐 자신에 대한 화남이었지만 지금은
상대가
있는 화남이다. 주로.
So it's like chocolate milk but like bananas.
Alright. 모르겠어요. 화를 잘 안 내서 잘 마시겠습니다.
Yeah, strawberry milk. Strawberry is my favorite.
지금은 이제 공중 전화에 들어가서 누구랑 통화하는데 전화를 안 받으니까 살짝 화나고 공허하고 짜증나네.
So it's just flavoring added to milk. It's not like. Nobody's milking bananas, right? Yeah, coffee's a flavoring though. Alright. But somehow bananas were out there getting milked.
깔끔하게 먹다. 그냥 이제까지 해본 적이 없는 컨셉인데다가 되게 다크하잖아요. 좀 센 느낌으로 한 건 처음이어가지고 뭔가 반전 매력? 그게 포인트인 것 같아요.
Do I milk a chocolate? What I do with chocolate in my own time is my own business, alright?
마무리됐습니다. 다섯 명 다 개인 씬 너무 잘 찍었다고 듣긴 했거든요. 뮤비가 어떻게 나올지 정말로 궁금하네요. 어둡고 세게 한번 표정을 잘해봤어.
They're trying so hard to be bad.
어때요? 멋있나요? 시작장 있고 딱 무덤 세트장에서 숨 쉬고
A little bit suggestive.
I like them bad. 정신 나간 과학자 같아요.
누가요?
형이요.
이건 안무
난이도는
거짓말하지 마요. 형 배울 때 어렵다고 막 저한테 막 붙잡고 물었잖아요.
I just thought it was like bananas, like pureed, like. And like mixed with water or something. Like you were like, it was like a banana juice thing or something.
오늘 너무 만족스럽게 잘 나온 것 같아요.
저는 솔직히 네. 세트장 보고 정말로 놀랐어요.
네. 지금까지 했던 뮤비 중에 군무가 제일 잘 나온 것 같아서.
맞아요.
순조로웠던 느낌이었어서 좀 너무 좋았어요.
맞습니다. 저도 이번 뮤비가 진짜 멋있게 나올 것 같아서 좀 기대 중입니다. 네.
뭐 2회차도 잘 마무리됐으니까 3회차에 또 군무가 있잖아요.
네. 마지막 날까지 잘 봅시다.
네. 열심히 해보고 파이팅 해보자.
좋습니다.
안녕.
안녕.
네, 오늘 굿보이 건밭 2일차 뮤직비디오 촬영이 끝났습니다. 야,
너무 재밌었습니다. 너무 재밌었고 약간 색다른 느낌의 또 뮤직비디오가 나올 것 같아서
맞아요. 촬영을 정말 너무 재밌게 잘 해주셔가지고 힘든 거 모르고 잘 마친 것 같습니다. 내일도 3일차 마지막 촬영이 있는데 기대 많이 해주세요.
파이팅!
파이팅! 안녕! 내일 봐요!
아, 진행도 얼마나 걸렸어요? 눈을 형상화. 오늘은 1절입니다, 1절.
1절 위주.
예, their choreography was pretty surprising on this album, or just in general. I was drawn in from their music first, so I wasn't sure, you know, how much choreography had to do with these guys, like, or how serious they took it. But they get some pretty imaginative moves. Yeah, I guess Big Hit's not just gonna like sign anybody, you know? They must have saw a huge potential in these guys. He's ruining that jacket.
욕심이 막 생기네요. 멋있게 잘 나오니까 귀마개.
Yeah, I noticed that Cabbage. I was trying to like pinpoint, like, all right, who's the rapper, who's the vocal person, who's, you know, they all seem to be kind of intertwined pretty well. Cool shot.
네, 오늘 GBGB 굿보이 건밭의 이제 뮤직비디오 촬영이 모두 다 끝났습니다. 야! 네, 오늘 이렇게 터널 씬으로 마지막으로 촬영을 했는데 너무 나이스하게 빨리빨리 해가지고 너무 다행이었고 또 뮤직비디오도 너무 예쁘게 나온 것 같아서 우리 모아분들이 기대를 해주셔도 좋을 것 같습니다.
아, 오랜만에 멤버들이랑 같이 뛰니까 너무 신나더라고요.
정말 어쨌든 눈이지 않을까.
아, 그렇습니다.
정말 예쁘니까 저희 뮤직비디오 많이 기대해주세요. 그럼 또 봐요!
안녕!
기대 많이 해주세요.
Alright. It's kind of cool, a little behind the scenes in the music video there.
네, 저희가 이제 굿보이 건밭.
Alright, what's this next one here?
나오기 전인데 저희가 또 항상 그랬듯이 미리 보고
Good Boy Gone Bad music video reaction. Oh, okay, we're breaking the fourth wall here, man. We're finally gonna see what these guys actually think of the music video.
리액션을 한번 해보도록 하겠습니다. 네, 가시죠.
제가 누를게요.
아, 오케이, 오케이.
Last bit and then a quiz.
하나, 둘, 둘, 둘. 저게 어떻게
되냐? 뉴슨 웰컴.
이제 이렇게 매트리스가 두 개가 있어요. 네. 그리고 쓰레기가 이렇게 있을 거 아니에요. 네. 처음에 이렇게 닫혀 있다가 전 여기에만 걸터 있어요. 중간에. 아. 중간에 이렇게 열리면 제가 빨려 들어가겠죠. 이걸 다시 이렇게 닫혀요.
아, 여는 거구나.
네. 그러면 제가 들어가면 여기 있는 쓰레기를 밀어서 이렇게 제 얼굴로 던져요.
와, 진짜. 와.
엄마가 블리즈도 알아봤나 봐요.
근데 게임하다가 불리나 안 돼?
알았네.
You look pretty satisfied so far.
우재팀한테 전화 하나 봐요.
아, 제발!
근데 카야 너 정말 잘 어울린다.
감사합니다.
나보다는 조금 아니긴 한데 나쁘지 않아.
스킨카?
오!
오!
야, 어떡해!
다친 데 없어요?
여긴데.
아, 아.
아, 멋있다.
아, 빨리 들어가 버려!
갑자기 형 눈이었구나.
변경 눈이었네.
뭐예요?
뭐 이게 마음에 안 들었어요.
형 진짜 아팠다고.
야,
찍을 것 같은데?
나 머리 탓이어서.
야,
용의 수준 소리가.
야, 너 목소리 잘했다.
진짜 질렀어?
아, 이게. 지르는 척 했지.
어제 최애 파티예요.
아, 여기? 그 형이 진짜 뭐라고 하는 거야?
They seem like fun dudes.
맞다?
And hearing that they're actually like pretty sweet guys is makes us all the more worthwhile.
아, 난 여기가 제일 좋았어, 엘리나.
고.
여기 너무 예쁘더라. 야, 엄청 성숙해졌네,
세현이가. 역시 흑발을 해야지 좀 지쳐져.
맞아요.
수빈이 형 너무 잘생겼다. 우와, 우와, 아니.
기다려봐.
아니 나 시인.
뭐야? 야, 범규야. 야, 내 차 탔어.
역시, 역시. 아는 사람 보면 안다고.
와!
와!
이거 오토바이 그냥 타는 거야. 아까 차
탔지. I got sound effects.
아, 진짜요?
어, 진짜? 멋있다.
예, 넘어지는 것만 이제 연기는 아니고, 아, 타는 거 연기는 아니고.
아,
그러다가 있잖아.
다들 이번에 뭔가 많이 부셨네.
와!
오, 예!
운전 미소.
아, 나 이거.
슬퍼, 슬퍼.
어.
어, 헤매 던졌어.
그럼 나의 몸
길에
나 빼고 누밖에 부러진 날.
어, 예. 오케이, 관뚜껑 덮어.
아우, 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 아우,
이거 진짜 세트가 말이 안 돼. 진짜 생선이야.
와우!
잘했다.
오,
연출 멋있다.
아,
아, 야, 멋있어. 아, 진짜 멋있어.
아우, 아우, 무슨 죽인다.
와,
잘했다.
누가 제일 죽여요?
난 수빈이 형.
나도 범규.
역시.
난 근데 연준이 형도.
아,
와, 진짜.
수빈이 범규 죽인다.
연준이
아, 이게 좀
죽인다.
여러 의미가 담겨.
진짜 죽인다. 어, 그쵸. 와, 그럼 제가 투표로 제가 제일 짱인 거네요.
맞네.
너가 제일 죽인다.
앞에 나온 관뚜껑에 들어갈 주인은 우리 범규로.
와!
아, 오늘 잘 나왔다.
뭐 네. 이렇게 해서 이제 1시간 반 뒤면은 지금 4시 반이거든요. 1시간 반 뒤에 뮤비가 나올 텐데
우리가 1시간 반 일찍 봤네.
우리 모아분들 기대 많이 해주시고 다 어땠어요?
모아분들이 좋아할 것 같아요.
그렇죠?
모아분들이 좋아할 것
같아요. 모아분 진짜 좋아하실 것 같은데.
네. 엄청 좋아하실 것 같아요.
다섯 명 다 캐릭터가 되게 확실한 것 같아서 난 보는데 좀 재미가 있긴 했어.
네. 맞아요. 맞아요. 우리 모아분들 굿보이 건밴 뮤직비디오 기대 많이 해주시고 재밌게 봐주세요.
네. 그럼 인사드릴까요?
좋아!
네, 인사드리겠습니다.
1, 2, 3! 지금까지
투모로우 바이!
축하드립니다! 감사합니다!
Even their goodbyes were like choreographed.
만사부!
만사부!
만부!
Yeah man, they seem like fun people! They seem like fun dudes! Let me kill this window thing here. They seem like fun dudes, apparently they're sweet. They're pretty good songwriters, vocals are top notch, they're fun to watch. Music videos are really fun too. Yeah. TXT is definitely on my radar. I'll be swinging around at some point. I definitely want to check out some of like their really early works and just kind of see how far they've come. But there's a reason they're on Big Hit. Big Hit's not going to mess around. They know they struck gold with BTS. I'm glad that they're not trying to do like a carbon copy of what BTS is, but I'm glad that they know some of the formulas of some of the things that work. And that's by putting good people, good musicians together, fun, engaging people to watch, and most importantly, actual talent together. They know what they're doing. They know what they're doing for sure. And they're not just going to sign anybody. But this has been fun. It's been a fun little album. I was surprised it was a little short, but I'm also, I also like the fact how it kind of wraps up pretty quickly, and it portrays a lot of emotions and a lot of feelings in a very short time. And it also takes you down, like, it's dark and it's kind of dreary in some parts, but it ends on a high note too, so it feels like overall it was like a true journey, even though it's only like five songs. So it's very well produced. It's very well put together. Seeing the behind the scenes, seeing like, you know, their process in the recording studio, and just seeing them kind of get nervous and making these little mistakes here that you make when you're kind of a newer musician, just working like in a mic booth and whatnot. It was kind of cute to see. It was kind of funny. I feel like I got to know a little bit more of their personality, just a little bit, just by seeing some of these behind the scenes things. Watching the music video and the making of, I thought that was really interesting. The live performances was something else. I was also taken back too by, you know, how intense the choreography, not intense, but how much work they put into the choreography. Like, it was, some of those movements were actually quite beautiful. I didn't know that they were choreography focused. You know, I've always been drawn into the music with these guys, but I haven't really seen too much or really any of their live stuff. So I was kind of taken back by the choreography and exactly, honestly, how beautiful it was. But yeah, they seem like solid dudes. They seem like they get along really well together. Seems like they have a pretty cool dynamic together. And yeah, this is a group you want to keep your eye on. So these guys are gonna, I know they're already probably mega famous now, but I think these guys, they've got the potential to do some really big things. And as long as they stick with it and, you know, stay true to themselves and have some decent values and everything, I think they're gonna have an insane career out of them. You'll send me some more TXT videos you might want to check out. Oh yeah, please do. Yeah, I would really appreciate that. But guys, seriously, like, the whole thing was brought to you by the team that we have on Discord, or one of the teams we have on Discord. Obviously it's Murr, Kit, Candace, and Cabbage that put everything together here for us. Like, they took time out of their days to really put together this whole list and the document and everything that we just saw. So seriously, make sure to thank them. Give them a big round of applause. Let's give them some air horns. Like, we're so lucky in this community to have such cool people that are willing to do this for all of us, you know? And I feel especially lucky because I feel like it's tailored just towards me. But this video is going to go out on YouTube. It's going to go on Patreon. It's going to be cut up and put into a bunch of different places. And because of your hard work, who knows how many people you just turned on to this band. So, I mean, you're really doing... You're doing some great promotion for the bands as well. So seriously, thank you for putting this whole thing together. For everybody watching and watching later and wherever you are, I hope you enjoyed this stream. I hope you enjoyed kind of hanging out and just kind of chilling. This is a really relaxed stream. I had fun. It felt like I didn't have to be as intense about the musical breakdowns with this because we had like explanation videos about like them in the studio and everything after. But this was a lot of fun for me. And I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do next with these guys, but they're 100% on my radar. And I think I'm really looking forward to hearing some of their early work because I want to, you know, compare how far they've come and where they are right now. But yeah, Thursday's Child's a cool little album. It's a badass little album. Oh, there's a quiz in the doc. Oh my God, let me see this document. Hold on. Am I doing this? Oh, okay. All right. Here we go. Based on, I'll answer some of these quiz questions, all right? All right, I'll do the quiz. I'm sorry. I thought you guys were just joking about a quiz. All right. Let's see here. Who do you think is the leader? Well, that's Sobin. I know who it is. I can't say his name right. Zubin? Sobin? Sobin? I don't know. I heard multiple things. Who's the oldest member? Who's the youngest member? I'm not sure. Yeah, I'm gonna, I will say, all right, let me, I'm gonna say Taehyun is the youngest. Am I right? Is Tae the youngest? Close enough? Close, almost? Who's the youngest? I got it wrong. Who is the youngest? I am wrong. My boy Kai's the youngest? Really? All right. Jeez, man. All right. All right, so I was close at least. All right. And did they tell me this? Did they give me these answers? And who is the young... Wait, I already did who is the youngest. I'm doing who's the oldest member. Let me take a look at these guys. I'm gonna say Yeojun. Yeojun is the oldest. Am I right? I don't know how to say his name. I got that one right? Oh, hell yeah. Money. 2 out of 3 is not bad, guys. 2 out of 3 is not bad. I'll take it. Air horns for me. Guys, this was a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Seriously, thank you so much. The team put everything together. I'll be back real soon. This Friday, I'm going to do something. Oh, I'm thinking about doing all those Discord suggestions on Friday. Everybody has been posting. I asked everybody, hey, is there any new cool music that I should check out for some new artists or new songs that are out there? I'm thinking I might do a live stream of just all those Discord suggestions on Friday. So if you want to send anything to me on that list, it's in the Discord section under new music recommendations or something. It's got a little siren thing next to it. I forget what I called it. Seriously, post it in there, and I'm going to try to get to as many as I can on the next Friday stream. I think that's what I have in the docket. So we got a lot of cool stuff. BTS stream on Sunday. New music on Friday. Live request on Wednesday. New BTS to my wife on Tuesdays, plus some scary stuff, plus another unboxing. So there's always something going on around here. But I hope you guys had fun today. I had a blast. Thank you all for watching. Thanks for being a part of this journey with me. And I'll see you guys all on Discord. Bye, everybody. Yeah, that was fun. I like that one. That was good. What song should I put on for the end? I already did Loser Lover. Let's do this one, whatever this is. I don't even know what song this is. Bye, everybody. You guys are great. I appreciate y'all being here. And now I'm by